Hi, welcome to today's session on case study, taper roller bearing selection from Manufacturers Catalogue. Myself, Professor Prashant Kushare. Learning objective of the today's session, select a taper roller bearing from Manufacturers Catalogue. In this session, we are going to select a taper roller bearing from Manufacturer's Catalogue for particular application. Let us see one of the problem or case study for which we have to select the taper roller bearing, or for this particular application we have to select a taper roller bearing. I have referred V. Bhandari's book, and this problem is taken from the same book. For this case study, I am going to read the problem statement. Transmission shaft transmitting 8 kilowatt power at 400 rpm from a bevel gear G1 to helical gear G2, mounted on two taper roller bearings B1 and B2 is shown in figure. Gear tooth process on the helical gear act as the pitch circle radius of 55 mm, while those on bevel gear can be assumed to act at the large end of the tooth at a radius of 50 mm. The diameter of the journal at the bearing B1 and B2 is 40 mm. Load factor is 1.2 and the expected life 90% of the bearing is 10,000 hours. Bearing B1 and B2 are identical. Thrust force due to bevel and helical gears is taken by the bearing B2. Select suitable taper roller bearing for this application. The first of all, read the problem statement carefully, and for this particular application, we have to select a suitable taper roller bearing. Now in this, first of all, write down the given data. You know very well, power 8 kilowatt at 400 rpm, two gears are mounted on the shaft, gear G1, that is bevel gear, gear G2, helical gear are mounted on two taper roller bearing B1 and B2, gear tooth process on the helical act as a PCD of the helical gear 55 mm, while here for the bevel gear 50 mm, diameter of the journal means shaft diameter is also given in this case. As earlier discussed, the procedure of selection of taper roller bearing in step 1, we have to find out the shaft diameter. But in this problem case study, diameter of the shaft, which is given at bearing B1 and B2, 40 mm, that means no need to calculate it. Load factor is given Ka, that is 1.2. Then here, expected life of the bearing, 90% of the bearing is 10,000 in hours, it's given. We have to convert into million revolution. Bearing B1 and B2 are added, both bearings are same. And thrust force due to bevel and helical gear is taken by the bearing B2, that means at bearing B2 that we have to locate in figure. Now let us see, it's shown in figure. Now here, this data, as I have mentioned, which is written here, power, RPM, helical gear, PCD, bevel gear, tooth at radius 50 mm, diameter of the shaft 40 mm, load factor 1.2, expected, it's a load factor, it's not a thrust load or axial load, try to understand. K, which is mentioned for a taper wheeling, it's a load factor. Expected life 90% of the bearing is 10,000 hours. L10H, which is given, and thrust force due to bevel and helical, which is taken by the bearing B2. We are going to select a suitable taper roller bearing. But before that, we should know the construction. Here is a inner race, it's called as a cone. It consists of your conic edge and the roller. And this is the outer race, is called as a cup. And you know arrangement here, the individual, this roller, which is having some inclination with the bearing axis, and because of this, you know very well, this taper roller bearing which withstand both radial as well as the axial loads. Again, the construction of this taper roller bearing is a separable construction, and line of action of this resultant, this reaction makes an angle with the axis of the bearing. Because of that, you will find here the radial as well as the axial components also. You have to take the care of this construction while calculating the process. Now I have constructed the figure as which is given here in the problem statement. This is the bearing B2 is also a taper roller bearing. B1 is also a taper roller bearing. Here helical gear, which is mounted in between these two bearing at a distance of 3 mm, from this side 150 mm, this side 150 mm, and at the here bevel gear, which is mounted from this bearing B1 at a distance of 100, is given in problem statement. It's a bevel, it's a helical gear, This is the, you know very well, because we have, what we have to do, diameter of the shaft is also given 40 mm, no need to calculate, but we should know, because at the bearing here, in the, it is mentioned in the problem statement, the thrust due to bevel and helical is taken by the bearing B2 here, B2, try to understand. Now let us see here, what we have to, this is bearing B2, this is bearing B1, this is helical gear, and these forces which is given in the figure, as I have taken from the name from Vivendari's book, all the forces are given here. 150, 150, this is the locations of from the bearing of this bevel gear as well as the helical gear. Again, this helical gear is having here the forces which acts on it, the 1 to 6 pi, the radial force 3470, axial force 1475, here also 1319 is the axial force, then radial and the tangential. All these are the forces already given in the year. But this bearing B2, for our purpose, we are going to say it's a bearing A, and here for a bearing B1, we are going to say it's a bearing B. Try to understand. This is a bearing A, and this is a bearing B in nomenclature. Now, again here, before selecting the bearing for this particular application, we know very well the face-to-face mounting, here this faces with each other, and another one is the back-to-back mounting. Because these things are required while selecting the bearing for back-to-back as well as the face-to-face mounting, by considering the different cases to find out the axial load, as discussed early in earlier session, selection procedure of taper roller bearing. Now, first step, how to select the bearing? So we have to calculate the radial as well as the axial forces acting on the bearing. And for that purpose, by using these forces, we are going to determine the diameter of the shaft. But in this problem statement, diameter of the shaft is given 40 mm. That's why no need to do this analysis or calculation part. Try to understand. Again, here what we have to do, but we have to find out the radial forces as well as the axial forces which are acting on it. How to find out it? Because two bearings and two gears are there, that's why considering the forces in vertical plane and moments at the bearing B1. This is the bearing B1. So consider the forces in vertical and moments at the bearing B1. So what you will get here, 3470 multiplied by 150 plus 439 into 100, this distance minus 139 here, it's given 1319, the axial component into this distance 50. Why 50? 50 is the PCD of, for this, the bevel gear, minus RV2 minus 300 is equal to, you will get RV2. Again, you can add the RV1, RV2, you will get RV1, 1370, you know very well. Many times we have did such a calculation. Then, consider the forces in horizontal plane and moments at bearing B1. So, what we have to do, again, same procedure we have to follow. Taking the moment at B1, we will get the horizontal component at 2, that is 2176 newton, and the equilibrium of forces you can edit, you will get RH1, 4731 newton. Once you will get this, we have to find out the resultant, the radial forces acting on the bearing. Now let us find out at the location 1 and at the 2. Now here, FR1 radial component at bearing 1 and FR2 radial component at bearing 2, RB1 square plus RH1 square. So you can substitute this value, you will get this FR1. Then FR2 is equal to RV under root RV2 square plus R2S square, you will get 2739 newton. And K, now here K already given in problem statement also, you know very well here. This 1319 and this 3473 which is going to act, we have to add it. The axial force K is equal to 1319 plus 14. Here we are using the K, the load factor nomenclature, but this is the axial force for the taper roller bearing. We have to add it, 2794, which is required here to find out the thrust component or thrust load at bearing 1 and bearing 2. Now bearing B2 is called the bearing A and bearing B1 is called the bearing B, as shown in figure. Therefore, FRA is 2739 and FRB 4926, and K, the addition of this axial force, 2794. These values we are going to use it. Now here, what we have to do, we have to select the construction or mounting of the bearing construction, whether face to face or back to back. But when we are going to say, here you will find FRA is less than FRB and K is greater than 0. That means this is the case, or in this case, and again here you will find K in our cases, all these forces, KA, look at this axial force, axial force, acts towards the left hand side. So you can go towards for the case number 2. In case number 2, this case 1, FRA is less than FRB. Look at this. FRA is less than FRB in K is greater than 0, this case. So this case is suitable to this, and from the figure you will get the year. From the book also you will find 1319 and 3473K axial force which acts towards the left hand side. Therefore, we have to use the case 2, and FRA is less than FRB, K is greater than 0. That means you have to use this relation. FA is equal to FAB plus K, and FAB is equal to 0.5 FRB to find out FAA and FAB. But before that, what you have to do? We have to make a decision about expected bearing life. To select the proper size of the bearing, we have to make the decision. But in this problem statement, life of the bearing which is given 10,000 hours. So by using this relation, L10 is equal to 60 into N into L10 in H by 10 raised to 6. You can substitute 10,000 hours, you will get L10 in million revolution. The year I am going to substitute this value, 60 into 400 is the RPM which is given in problem statement. 10,000 hours divided by 10 raised to 6, you will get 240 million revolutions. If it's not given, you can refer the chart and decide the life in million revolution and hours. Now, here shaft diameter 40 is given. Then I am going to select the bearing for shaft. Here number of bearings are available. But suppose take the bearings. Out of this 3 number bearing 30, 28, you can select this one, you can check it, no problem. But I have selected this bearing 30, 28. For this outer diameter of the bearing is 80, width is 19.75, dynamic load capacity 58,300 Newton. Here it's given designation 30, 28, E is equal to 0.37 and the Y is equal to 1.6. Now E is 0.37. What we have to do now, we have to find out the equivalent dynamic load. E is equal to 0.37, Y is equal to 1.6, and here you will find FRA is less than FRB, K is greater than 0. It's a case of 2. For a case FAB is equal to, as earlier I have told, you have to use this relation. By using this relation, you will get FAB is equal to 0.5 FRB by Y, you will get 1539 Newton, and FA is equal to FA plus K, you will get 43. By using this value, you have to check FRA by FRB ratio, whether it is greater than E or less than E. Based on that, you can find out the equivalent dynamic load. P is equal to FR when FA by FR is less than E, and when FA by FR is greater than E, you have to use this equation 0.4 FR plus YFA to find out equivalent dynamic load. Now let us check it by using this relation, whether FA by FR is less than E or greater than E. If I am going to check it, you will find FA by FRA is equal to 1.58 is greater than E. That means you have to go for this equation. Equivalent dynamic load 0.4 FR plus YFA. Now here, for a bearing A, FRA is equal to 2739. FA is equal to 4333.38 Newton. And it's greater than E. That means you have to use this equation. By using this equation, you will get equivalent dynamic load, that is 8029 Newton. For bearing B, similarly, you can do the same calculation. FRB is equal to 4926 and FAB 1539. If FAB by FRB is equal to this ratio 0.31, it's less than E. Try to understand. Less than E. Our E is equal to 0.37. Here it's calculated 0.31, less than E. When it's less than E, you have to go for equivalent dynamic load. P is equal to FR. When FA by FR is A, that means P is equal to radial load. The radial load here 4926. That's why equivalent dynamic load 4926. I hope you got this, because what you have to do for both bearing A and bearing B, you have to decide based on FI by FRA ratio, whether greater than E or less than E. Based on that, you can use the equation to find out the equivalent dynamic load. Once you have calculated equivalent dynamic load, you have to use load life relationship. By using this load life relationship, we can easily calculate the dynamic load capacity of the bearing. So we know very well the L10 is equal to C by P raised to P, where C is equal to P in bracket L10 in raised to 1 by P. Here small p indicates the 10 by 3 power taper roller bearings and 3 power the ball bearing, as discussed in earlier session. By using the same relation, we are going to calculate the dynamic load capacity of the taper bearing. So what we have to do, once dynamic load capacity is calculated, we have to check in the chart whether which is less than the selected bearing or greater than it. If it's less than the selected bearing, you can select the same bearing. If it's greater than, you have to go for the second option by referring the this chart from the manufacturer's catalog. Now here, for this bearing 3028, the dynamic load capacity 58,300. So what we have to do? We have to check for this. Now, after calculating the dynamic load capacity for the bearing A, the same relation, load life relation, I am going to use here multiplied by load factor 1.2, which is given in problem statement. You will find here, L10 is 240, P is 8029, you will get 49,877 Newton. But here for selected bearing, dynamic load is 58,300. That means calculated value is less than this. That means this bearing is suitable. Similarly, we can check for the bearing B, load life, by using load life relation, CP equation here. Now, this is P into L10 raised to 0.3 here. This is raised to into load factor 1.2. Again, calculated value 30,601. Again, it is less than the 58. That means so the selected bearing 3028. This taper bearing is suitable. If it's greater than this 50,300, what you have to do? You have to go for the second option. Second option means this, this one or this one, no problem. Again, you have to select and do the calculation for again this case also. So this is about the bearing selection. That means the bearing number 3028 is suitable at A as well as the suitable at B. Thank you. Thank you very much. I have referred V. Bhandari's book. Thank you.